Writers' nights are the primary form of communication for songwriters in town. And they are split between the open mic, which is anybody that shows up can play, and the songwriters' night, which is an invitation thing. The way most people start out is on an open mic, and most writers' nights will have an open mic either before or after the writers' night. Now, we have what's called the writers' round, which would be between three and four writers on stage at the same time. Everybody plays one song, it goes right down the line, come back around, play another song, goes right down the line, and you do that for three songs. Three songs are basically what Nashville is built around. There are the featured section, which would be someone with cuts or publishing deals that play usually in the middle of the night. You would love to be around those. How do you get in them? Once again, referral. Usually start in an open mic, you prove yourself to the host, you meet other writers, people that you communicate with, that you write with, then they'll maybe put a round together, or you might put a round together, and that's where you get two or three of your friends to get up with you, and you all play songs. And sometimes you've written together, sometimes it's people that you've met, sometimes people that you want to work with. There's a variety of all of it. The best thing to do, in my opinion, is to try and keep as much mid and up tempo and positive as much as possible. On an average writer's night, there'll be 30 writers, 25 to 30 writers, all playing three songs each. That's between 75 and 90 songs. And if you can imagine 70% of those songs being ballads, being negative, being depressing, that's what you're up against with most songwriter nights. So if you have mid or up tempo and positive songs, you're gonna stand out. That's going to make you stand out in the eyes of the host. That's going to make you stand out in other people, get you more attention. And people want to be around somebody who's positive. How many times have you ever woken up and going, well, I sure want to feel crappy today, and I sure want to feel bad, and let me go whine a little bit. There are three things that you can't do on songs: preach, vent, and whine. And that's what most songwriters do, because they write from a position of pain. This is my stuff. Oh, God. Oh, poor, poor, pitiful me. So if you keep it up, tempo, you're going to get more attention, and you're going to get a better position on the writer's night, maybe work yourself into a feature. Then the etiquette is to get on stage as quickly as you can. Make sure your guitar is in tune or your keyboard is set up. Get a good sound. Get a good microphone sound. And then you start playing. Some people want to start their songs out with a 5-minute story about how they wrote that song. Mostly we don't care. Don't bore us. Get to the chorus and get your songs and do a nice little showcase for yourself. You also have about a 3.5 to 4 minute window with your setup and your song. You should be able to do them all in about 15 minutes of your little thing. And the writer's round is just an extension of that. The reason there are rounds is because it brings people and makes them stay to eat and drink and support the venue. And that's another thing. Bring your friends. Advertise for yourself. If you bring a large crowd in, you're going to find yourself in a feature pretty quickly.